His latest thing is where he said, no one wants to see curvy women. No one wants to see them on the catwalk. This group of women, and I won't try to say the name of the group in French because I'll screw it up, but in English it translates to beautiful, round, sexy, and I'm okay with it. That's their group's name. He said these defamatory and derogatory statements, and they're just not going to stand for it anymore because they feel like that it is showing little girls everywhere that their bodies and who they are is not right. So they wanted to file suit against
them. Emmy, people taking a stand for something that you and I, many people have believed for a long time. What do you make of this? Especially French women.
I love it.
Taking a stand on
Michaela,
this.
I love this. I love hearing how French women are taking a stand where fashion is the, you know, where fashion is, where it's really this cornerstone of all of our lives. Women in Korea, women in Italy, women in Brazil, women in America are starting to use their voice on social media for these issues. Around body and around, wait a minute, you can't say this to me. This does not make me feel good. It's not just women who are around, it's women in general, mothers, aunts, grandparents, and women who are curvy that are like, you can't bully me anymore. No more. That's
no
it.
More. Yeah. And he, as you said, he's known to say outrageous things. That's not an excuse, though, for these comments, that's for sure.
Right.
But does this also get to the point that we shouldn't be taking the lead from a fashion designer, maybe, on how we should feel about ourselves?
Exactly. I think that's a really, really good point. You got to see, you know, seek the source. He lives his life the way he does. So let's just keep his comments at a low roar.
But
don't take them personally.
Something that's very interesting. Karl Lagerfeld himself used to be a hefty fella.
Yes.
He used to be over 200 pounds and lost an extreme amount of weight, and he actually said that fashion for him was his influence to an inspiration to live a healthier life and to get thin.
And to Kate's point, though, this group of women is also saying it's just that reason, because of his cachet, that we are holding him accountable, because there are people like him, the little girls listen to what these fashion designers say, so we need to hold him accountable.
Right. I think that, you know, look, I'm raising two daughters, right?
How old are they?
10 and 3.5 going on 27. And, you know, we often hear the thing, the expression, women dress for other women. You know, women are other women's harshest critics. You know, and Lagerfeld, I agree with, try to make him as irrelevant as you can as quickly as possible.
That's
because you want to separate that out. But when you get into even nomenclature, like a plus size model, you're a model, you're a beautiful woman. That should be it. You know, people come in lots of different varieties.
I often feel when I watch my
daughter 10 years old, and she is beautiful. Certainly nobody
She's
will convince me of anything
times
else.
Right now.
And I see her looking at what other women have on. And I think there's got to be an empower movement from within as well.
Thank
I'll tell you,
Dad.
I went to the Giorgio Armani show the other night. Love Giorgio Armani, Italian, right? Yep. Must be good. My mother spent the entire night. I went with my mom and my wife, two most beautiful women there. And my mother spent her whole night looking at the women in the dresses and going, what is wrong with her? So you got to reinforce the image for men. My mother takes such a time to look at the girls. You look beautiful. Know that about yourself. No, that's got to be in there too. Forget about him. You know, cut out the dumb statements. Worry about empowering yourselves. You know.
The one point that really hitting it home time and time again is the diversity of beauty.
Absolutely.
That what you see in the magazines.
Look at this table.
Yeah. Look at us.
And then me.
That's why we love Mr. Cuomo.
Four fingers and the thumb.
But the diversity, we really truly have to embrace that. And when you take a look at a cover of a magazine, or if you take a look at an image that you see on a billboard, tell your kids that the eyes have been redone, the neck has been elongated, the body has been elongated, everything's been redone to be this kind of image that's not a real image.
Well, I have a face full of makeup, head full of weave, and lashes on.
So it's an image.